Hi guys, Luton here, and I'm on some Air Superiority for you. Now, you guys know from some of the footage I've posted, I'm not the best pilot in the world, by far and away, and I think it'd be fair to say a lot of people playing right now are feeling this same thing. But one thing that's really frustrating everyone is the height ceiling of the air combat. It's really low. And the other problem people keep having is the stalling. I keep having this, everyone keeps having this. You know how frustrating it is. You're straight up in the air chasing someone, and you suddenly hit that air ceiling, you get stalled. Well, I've been playing around quite a bit. I've been trying to just practice and learn a few things as well, and I've actually figured out like how you can break out of these stalls. I was trying out a few different things, trying to get around it. I found it really frustrating, really irritating that you can't simply just get out of these stalls. Anyway, I actually looked around as well. I searched. This isn't a new thing. I searched up as well stalling. I was actually flying around with this, and I was just trying to break out of it, hitting the afterburner different ways. And then afterwards, I figured it out. I was like, okay, I've got to look around. So this is a good one to know. This is a good one to know for everybody. You should really know this. Sometimes you can break out of it first time. Sometimes it will take like a couple of tries to get out of it. In air superiority mode, you may find it difficult. You may just get shot down while you're sitting there, even when you're trying to use this technique to get out of it. But regardless, at least you know how to get out of it, and it means that you know you don't have to just sit there. You can at least try. The air height on this level, this is Riverside, I haven't checked for all of them so far. The air height at the max is about 500 on this. It's so small. I think Carg Island it's like 1,000. A couple of the maps in vanilla it's like 1,000. 500 on this, it's really low. I think the idea they've deliberately done it is to try and keep everyone low down, to try and keep the gameplay interesting. Anyway, okay, so let's go on to stalling. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to level off. All right, I'm just going to go up. Now watch as well the height here. My height is the top right value here on the screen. And you can see that we're doing fine. And then all of a sudden, look, we hit that at about 500. And we've gone into a stall. And see, like, I can't get out of this. Now what we're going to want to do, even though it looks like we're moving, we're not. We're just stationary, okay? It keeps bouncing you up and down between about 400 and 500. Now I'm holding the air brake. I'm holding the brake now. You can see that number is going to come dropping down slightly. And this is about as low as, there we go, right, it's dropping. Keep that number dropping down. And when it gets a bit lower, okay, when we start losing as much out, right, now we're going to hit the afterburner. And then you see how the plane starts to move? Okay, now we're going to drop it off again. That didn't work perfect that time. Sometimes, as I say, you can break out of these very quick, sometimes not. Right, now I'm hitting the afterburner. And I'm moving, and there we go, look. Okay, now it hasn't fully broken, so again, holding the brake here. As I say, I've done a couple this evening already while I was testing where you break out first time. Okay, I'm going to get it led to about 400. I'm going to hit that afterburner again. There we go, I see it breaking out the stall. Now, as I say, you'll have different success on this depending on how it's going, how you're just generally controlling, how level your plane is and all the rest of it. It seems to work better on different maps. I did try one other map. Let's go up again. So we're going up. And we're going to hit that barrier when it gets, there we go, 500. I'm just going to start holding it. If you hit it straight away, we've gone right up to 600 here. Now I'm holding the air brake. Drop off that figure. Come on, get down. Get it down to like 400. There we go, hit the air afterburner. Turn the jet. It doesn't seem to ever want to break out on this level. I say a couple of times I've tried it. And we're not at a perfect angle either now, which is really not ideal. I'm going to hold it again. As I say, the trouble is, on air superiority mode, you may find, there we go, see, second time out. It seems that it takes a couple of goes to get out on this one. Now, that took me about 5-10 seconds. If the guy who was behind you stalled as well, there is a fair likelihood that maybe you won't get shot down, but regardless, it's a little bit tricky. Let's just try one more time, see if we can break out of it one on the first time, alright? So we're heading up. There we go, braking it. Okay, hit the brake immediately. My wings are leveled off. So we're dropping numbers. Come on, drop down. Getting into that altitude a little bit. Okay, afterburner's on. We're nearly breaking out of it. Come on. There you go. So first time round. See what I say? If you hit it straight away and you do it right, you can break out of that stall straight away and then you'll be back in the combat. Hope that's been a big help, guys. Hope you've enjoyed. As I say, use this technique. Let me know how you get on. Make sure to tell other people so we can get some more interesting combat going on. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time for some more Battlefield 3 tips, tricks, and tactics with Luton. Cheers.